This week, we're looking at Acadians in the middle of the 18th century. We're looking at the period leading up to the expulsion. We're not actually going to examine the expulsion. We're going to look at the people that we're talking about. We're looking at how the British view these people, how they interact with the Mi'kmaq peoples. And the readings this week really take us to politics. They really take us to how these people were fitting into the bigger world of imperial issues and what role they would play in the larger imperial struggle. Because remember, from your introductory materials, the Seven Years' War is about to begin. They know a war is about to begin. It's been brewing for years. And they're trying to figure out how to deal with these people. But what I want you to see here today, right now, in this video, is a little bit about who those people were. And again, you'll recall from your introductory materials, I was telling you that much of the ability of the Acadians to withstand a neutral position in these imperial struggles was based on their agriculture. And I talked about their salt marsh based agriculture, the dike lands that they built together as communities for the farms that they built. Right now we're on the shore of the Bay of Fundy. You can hear it and the wind coming in off the bay. This is the Atlantic Ocean. The Bay of Fundy leads into the Atlantic Ocean. My left, your right. You see a farm there in the background. But what I really want you to see here in this video is what I'm standing on and how that stretches all the way down along that shore off towards that farm in the background over there. That's a farm, and this is a dike, and this is holding the ocean back. This is the Bay of Fundy. The tides here run 10, 11, 12 meters depending on the season, depending on the time of the year. That's 10, 12 meters. That's a huge amount of salt water. Soil that has been drenched with salt water. But the Acadians build these massive dikes to hold back salt water, to allow the salt water to drain back out through the dikes. They have a sluice system set up to allow that salt water to drain off. And the result is this magnificent farmland that you see behind me. We have over 3,000 acres of really top-notch farmland behind here. Deep, deep topsoil. Very, very fertile. And really some of the best farmland in eastern North America. Fairly limited. We're talking about a 100-mile stretch of riverbank, tidal rivers along the shore, but still very, very good soil, very good agricultural possibilities. Acadians built those dikes not like New England farmers built their farms by themselves, individually, or by the family. They built them in village groups. They built large family groups coming together to build them. And the strength of those communities really stems from the fact that they work together as communities to build these massive, impressive structures. I can't stress enough how impressive these things are. These ones here today are maintained with heavy equipment, with bulldozers and heavy equipment like that. They're built in the 18th century by hand, with shovels and carts and horses. Incredible engineering feats done by very ordinary people because they work together.